Now, the first type of effects that I'd like to talk about are the color, brightness, and power effect controls. Now, the reason I want to talk about these first and why they all are related is they all modify the shape or the frame that you're using by modifying the points. And they also use the same attributes and effect things down here, so you can end up having, you can modify them. They all work the same way. So once you learn one, you can learn how the other ones work fairly easily. Now, with color effects, power effects, brightness effects, we start off with the 0 to 100% keyed area. And what this basically does is while we're on color effect, at point 0, it'll be here. And at point 100%, which happens to be point 200, it'll go across this and it'll go it through the points. So let's say we just made this white, right? And all of a sudden, halfway through then the points of the frame, it's white. Now you can go and add whatever keys you want, whatever colors you like to do, whatever color combination you can come up with. It's all there. It's easy to use. Now, a quick little feature that you're going to use all the time with this is if you have a bunch of colors in here, if you right-click, you can allocate all colors linearly, which means it'll even it out. All you need to do to create them is double-click on an empty area and it'll bring up the color. And you can right-click and delete them if you don't like them. Now, this also goes into the attributes. So what you can do with the attributes here is you can have them repeat. So say you want to have this on this on the shape here be twice, three times, four times, five times, doesn't matter, whatever you'd like to do. And it'll modify it and place it on there five times. The other thing you can do is have speed, and you can have it move around based on time. And like I said, with beats or time. And we're going to talk about how those work a little bit later. What we can also do is time shift, which has to do with kind of that it offsets where it starts. And then you can change how much the color will actually affect or how much the brightness and those things will actually affect the frame themselves. And these we'll talk about otherwise. These are a little bit more advanced features. If you'd like to, you can add the speed options. So this has to do with the movement. If you want it to go back and forth instead of being linear, or if you want to do those types of things, you can do that as well. We're going to go into specifics of that later on, but you can use those there too. Now, the reason why color and power and brightness effects are all very similar is because of this. If you add any of these color, brightness, or power effect, you're going to get these same attributes, and this little option bar will come up. And if you click on this, it gives you quite a few options. Now, in here, what you can do is you can change it from color control, hue and saturation, and hue shift, which are all about colors, brightness control, or power effect. So if we click on the brightness control, your bar now turns, instead of colors, into brightness. So you can click and add and say, oh, I want this part to be 100 and I want this part over here to be, you know, 0. You can go in there and make those adjustments. And now it's all about color and all the same attributes of repeats, speed, time shift, the blend, and the speed action, all those types, the accelerations, all those are the same as they were with the color. Now, the other one is power control. In power control, what it does is it's a multiplication of points. So if you say your shape has 200 points, in this percentage area, you can modify repeats. So if we bring this down to 1, and say we'll do this, we'll bring the repeats down here. If you look at here, well, this will turn the speed off. What we've done now is we've multiplied these points. And if I move this, you can see where the multiplications change up over here. So if we delete this, if we just delete these, a couple of these, so we can have a better viewing angle, you can see how the power effect modifies itself and use in it. Modifies the shape up on the top corner there, up over here. So power effect, again, has the same attributes as the color and brightness. Now another cool we can do, if we go back to color control, and let's just make this, I don't know, let's do red. Actually, we'll make this red, we'll delete this, and we'll say we'll make this, who knows, yellow or something. The next thing we can do, though, is this is by points. So we're modifying the points by the 0 point to 1 point to 100%, which is happens to be 200 points here with the shape, or whatever your shape ends up being. Other options, though, is we can do it by x-axis. So depending on its value on the x-axis, it'll change it. We can do it by the y-axis. So depending on the y-axis, it will change it. And we can do it by things like the z-axis if you're working in depth. We can do it by radius, so the farther it goes out, the more intense it'll get. We can do it by time, and so by if you add time here, it'll do all of that within the second of the time, whether it's 1 second or it's one beat or whatnot. And these things, options, can be used all again for power effects and those sorts of things.